This weekend, ballots are arriving in mailboxes and voting is underway in the midterms. With us, the Republican candidate for governor of California, Brian Dahle, plus a debate over sports betting with the leaders from Prop 26 and Prop 27, and the Republican candidate for state controller, Lanhee Chen. The Issue Is starts right now.
Broadcasting across California, you're watching The Issue Is.
And welcome to The Issue Is. I'm Elex Michaelson. With us here on the set is the Republican candidate for California governor, state senator, Brian Dahle. Welcome to The Issue Is. Good to have you here.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
All right. Let's start with the first question that I think a lot of people want to know about you. Who are you? Because there's a lot of people that still don't know that much about you. And why are you running for governor?
Well, first you should know that my family's been in California for 92 years. We're farmers. I have a cereal grain business. We raise seed for other farmers, certified organic. Served 16 years on the Lassen County Board of Supervisors before I went to the legislature. Served 6.5 years in the assembly and 3.5 years in the state senate.
And what made you say, I got to run for governor?
Well, I don't want to leave California. Many of my neighbors and friends and people I know are leaving California, and it's really tough to do business in California. That's why I got engaged in politics in the first place, was to represent our communities and families here in California. And so I had the opportunity to run for this position, and feel like I'm well qualified. I've been in the legislature for 10 years, and I'm looking forward to representing California and keeping those people back here in California.
A big reason that a lot of people are leaving is because they're frustrated, especially with the homelessness situation. It's issue number one. If you won, you would most likely face a Democratic supermajority. What could you actually get done when it comes to homelessness?
Well, first, you should know I've been in the legislature and I've worked across the aisle because I'm a Republican. You have to get things done. So that's number one. I know how to work across the aisle. Number two, homelessness is really three issues. It's drug addiction, which is a really big part of it, mental illness, and then housing. And there's a fourth one, too, which is, you know, Gavin Newsom let out 30,000 prisoners during COVID, and those people had nowhere to go. So a lot of them are on our streets as well. So number one, we need to stop the flow of drugs in here. We need to get these people rehabilitated off of drugs. And then we need to get more clinicians for mental health. And then the third thing is ratchet down our permitting process for housing so we can actually get them in a house. And that will help them get off the streets. And the other thing you should know is coming out of local government, which I served at a long time, they're the ones that are going to do the work. So we need to empower local governments. That means not from the top down like we've seen in California. We give the money to the cities and the counties so they can actually rehabilitate these people in the jurisdictions throughout the state.
You know, the other issue that is most on people's minds right now is gas prices. We are seeing them skyrocketing in California, not really around the country, but for some reason here in California, some $2 more than the national average. Why is that happening? And what could you do as California governor to bring that down? Because Governor Newsom says he wants to do a windfall profits tax potentially the beginning of next year.
Well, his answer to everything is tax, and give him the money and he'll spend it better. I actually think we need to drive down the price of gas. We can do that by reducing the taxes that are already there. We pay about $1.28 more than other states in taxes. We pay average over 2 gallons, and that's because we have in California a special blend that we have that you can only buy in California. It's only produced in California. Those regulations have caused gas prices to go up, and there's a shortage. He told the oil companies, hey, we're going to put you out of business in 13 years by putting electric cars in California. So if you're in business, why would you expand your operation to make more fuel when you're going to be put out of business? So we need to have a long-term plan for our, because we use 1.8 million barrels a day, and by 2035, he expects that not to happen. That won't happen.
Let's talk about the state of this race. We've offered to host a debate on this show, a televised debate. The governor decided to do a radio-only debate on KQED on a Sunday afternoon competing against NFL football and Major League Baseball playoffs. I think they're going to broadcast that on public TV afterwards. What do you make of that decision? And what do you make of the fact that he wants to do a debate with Governor Ron DeSantis on CNN?
Obviously, I want to debate him anywhere, any place, anytime. I'd like for it to be where people of California can see it. He doesn't want to debate because he doesn't want to have to talk about his failures in California. We have the highest taxes and the highest crime. We have homelessness. We have education issues. We have wildfires, drought. Name one thing Gavin Newsom's actually fixed since he's been in office. He doesn't want to talk about that. He wants to talk about Ron DeSantis. I just believe that he doesn't want to talk about his failed policies.
yet, polls show that he's up big. He defeated John Cox, his Republican opponent, in 2018 by about 25 points. He defeated the recall by about 25 points. He was ahead in the spring primary by 40 points. How do you beat him?
Well, that's a great question. California is a blue state, but I'm hearing from people that are out on the campaign trail, independents, Democrats, Republicans, that, you know, they can't afford to live in California. They're saying, I've been blue to the core. I'm going to vote for you, Brian, because I want a better school for my children. I want change. We need balance in California. We've had 25 years of one-party control, and what has it gotten them? So there is an opportunity. We're given that opportunity for balance in California. The greatest thing about being the governor is you get the appointments to all the agencies, and the second thing is you got a pen that you can veto with, and that's what we need, some balance in California.
We play a game on this show called Personal Issues, where we get to know you a little bit better. So this is 30 seconds, and we have a little bit of fun. So let's see what comes top of mind as we get to know you. All right, ready? What is your favorite movie?
Tombstone.
What's your favorite type of music?
80s rock and roll.
What's your favorite way to relax?
Get in my tractor and farm, actually.
All right. Favorite sport to play?
I like to play cornhole, actually. It's my new sport I've been playing.
That is fun. Who's your favorite Democrat?
I would say that would be Susan Telemantis Eggman. She's an assembly member from Stockton.
Okay, and what's your favorite TV show?
My favorite show is with Kevin Costner.
It's Yellowstone.
Yellowstone.
Okay, I knew that you were going there. It's hard to predict that one, but okay. Yellowstone. Well, we're going to have a debate on online betting for sports. But we go to break with some incredible video from a farm. This is called the Historic Hawes Farms. And they made a corn maze of your face. Brian Dahle, what went through your mind when you saw that?
Well, I think it's really amazing. They've done Johnny Cash. They've done a lot of national things. They've got national attention for the corn maze. I actually know them. I worked for them like 30 years ago, and they called me last June and said, hey, can we do this? And I'm like, great. So they cut it, and we went out there just last week, actually, and they revealed it. Pretty neat.
All right, yeah, you never, the fun part of running for governor, right? Thank you so much for coming in. Best of luck out there on the campaign trail. We go to break with more of Brian Dahle's face. Stay with us, you're watching The Issue Is.
The give to Cup, and Cup with a lot of room down the sideline.
Should sports betting be legalized in California? In 2018, the Supreme Court gave the states the ability to expand their betting options, and about half the states already have. This year, $400 million has been spent on campaigns hoping to convince you to allow betting in this state. There are two options on the ballot. Proposition 26 would allow in-person sports betting at tribal casinos and horse racing tracks, but not online. Prop 27 would allow online sports betting on computers and mobile devices outside of Native American tribal casinos. The state estimates it could raise about $500 million to combat homelessness. The spokespeople for both campaigns are here for a special Issue Is debate. Kathy Fairbanks is for Prop 26 and against Prop 27. Nathan Klick is for Prop 27. Nathan, let's start with you. This really comes down to, why should sports betting be on my phone? Why is that the way to go?
Absolutely. Thank you for having us on. Wanted to start out by saying, you know, there's a real difference between Prop 26 and Prop 27. If you care about the state budget, about generating revenue to help solve homelessness, Prop 27 generates millions of dollars, hundreds of millions of dollars each year. Prop 26 offers very little for the state in terms of revenue. If you want a safe and responsible online sports betting marketplace, Prop 27 delivers that, puts the AG in charge of all the regulation. Prop 26 leaves every casino to regulate itself. And if you want to help small and non-gaming tribes, only 27 delivers real additional revenue for those small and non-gaming tribes. So for all of those reasons, Prop 27 is by far the best solution for California.
Kathy, why is Prop 26 the answer?
26 is the answer, supported by tribes, written by tribes, will allow in-person sports betting in responsible fashion in regulated tribal casinos and regulated horse tracks where sports betting is already happening. That gives people the ability to ensure that underage kids aren't going into the casino and gambling. It's a good way to introduce sports betting in California. In contrast, Proposition 27 is a massive expansion of gambling. It's opposed by 50-plus tribes. It was written by 7 out-of-state corporations to benefit them. 90% of the revenues immediately go out of California. Only 10% is left, and of that 10%, there are loopholes written into Prop 27 allowing them to whittle that down to pennies on the dollar.
Nathan, what do you say to that argument that if it's just on a phone, you know, a 16-year-old, a 10-year-old, anybody could sports bet?
If you talk to all of the problem gaming experts, they'll tell you that the safe and regulated online sports betting marketplace actually does a really good job of preventing kids from accessing those platforms. And I think it's pretty disingenuous for Kathy, who about half of her tribal coalition is supporting a 2024 ballot measure that would legalize online sports betting in just 2 years, to say, you know, this is an unsafe platform, when about half of her coalition wants to do the exact same thing in 2 years.
So you're saying they want to do it, just want to make the money from it?
The only tribes that support that potential 2024 measure that no longer looks like it's going to qualify are the three that are funding the ballot measure.
NIGA has endorsed that.
No, it's a little misleading.
The entire coalition of...
The point is that, you know, as it goes back to your question about underage gambling, FanDuel was just in trouble in Indiana and New Jersey in 2021, last year, for marketing to underage kids. DraftKings, in its February 2022 filing with the Securities and Exchange Commission, identified that their platform was susceptible to bad actors, which included fraudulent use of credit cards, fake accounts being set up, and things like that. So we've got a problem where it's not 100% foolproof, you know, and someday, maybe in a few years, we'll get there. We're just not there yet. And parents are concerned.
Kathy's leaving herself the room and her clients the room to say, oh, yeah, in 2 years, it's all better.
No, not 2 years. It's all maybe 2 years, and maybe 4 years, or maybe 10 years.
But isn't this happening in states all over the country right now?
Very safely.
And what we're seeing in other states, calls to problem gambling hotlines are increasing. In New Jersey, 500% increase in calls to the problem gambling hotlines just since they instituted online sports betting. And there are other states that are in that same situation. So it's, you know, I'm not saying that all of those are kids, but it's a problem.
Well, under 27, we're creating the safest, most responsible online sports betting platform in the country. And let's talk about those problem gaming protections in Prop 27. Anyone who's experiencing problem gaming, with one click of a button, can self-exclude from all of the platforms. And immediately, those platforms, it's illegal for them to take online sports bets from that person, up to a $100,000 fine. There's no fines in Prop 26 for any operator or any casino that takes an underage bet.
All of this could be a moot point, because speaking of betting, if you had to bet right now, you would have to bet against both of these propositions from passing. After $400 million spent, the recent poll results from Berkeley and the LA Times, not really great for either one of you. On Prop 26, 31% support, 42% opposed. It's even worse for Prop 27, 27% support, 53% opposed. Of course, you have to get over 50%. It is possible that both of these pass. It's possible that neither one of them pass. Why do you think this isn't doing better after all this money that is being spent? And do you think that maybe the two of you are killing each other with all this money that's being spent?
Look, we're undaunted. We've got 30 days to go before the election. But there is a truth to something you said. Kathy's coalition spent $45 million before we even qualified for the ballot. They've spent another $100 million against us in false and misleading attack ads. We're out there telling the truth, telling what our initiative does, how it would benefit the state, and we're moving forward.
What happens if neither of these things pass?
I think there will be litigation. But back to, I just want to talk about the ads and things like that. It's very clear voters are confused. And when they're confused, they generally vote no. They've had a number of misleading ads. They've spent more than $100 million trying to convince voters that tribes are in support of Prop 27. Three tribes support Prop 27. 50-plus oppose it. It's not a solution to homelessness. Voters aren't buying that. They don't think it's a money issue. They think it's a government problem, program problem. They've been promised this before. The lottery is going to fix education.
What Kathy isn't telling you is that her campaign has spent no money behind yes ads to prop up their initiative, which the OC Registered called a cynical ploy. They're not doing it because they know they're not they're not spending money on their ads because they know it's a bad solution for California.
All right. Well, it'll be interesting. And if neither one of these pass, it's you got to think a lot of people are going to be betting anyways. It's just money that's not going to go to the state of California.
Absolutely.
Right? So we're going to ask you to make one bet because, you know, that's what we're doing here. Who would you bet on to win the World Series? Kathy.
Oh, gosh. Okay. I don't even know who's potentially
Remember what state you're in. Remember what city you're in.
Oh, the Dodgers are
okay. They are the
favorites. Then I would definitely support them. Yes.
Okay.
I have to say I'm not that well versed in sports, but go blue, go Dodgers.
Okay. Well, that's a smart answer.
If you'd asked an NFL question, I would have.
Lanhee
known
Chen is up next. Who is a big Dodger fan. We leave you both with the above Los Angeles account taking us above Dodger Stadium and some I love LA because they are the betting favorites to win the World Series. Great to see you both. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Imagine buying a house and not paying the mortgage. Malia Cohen did. Imagine not paying your business taxes and having your license revoked. Malia
Cohen did. That is the latest campaign ad from Republican Lanhee Chen, who is running for controller against the Democratic candidate Malia Cohen. He's hoping to be the first Republican to win statewide since 2006. He's backed by the editorial boards of the LA Times, Orange County Register, San Diego Union-Tribune, San Jose Mercury News, and LA Daily News, many of which don't often back Republicans. Lanhee Chen, welcome back to The Issue Is.
Thank you.
To have you in-house for the first
time.
Great
to be
welcome
here.
Welcome to
Beautiful
the studio.
Beautiful set. Thank you.
You very much. Okay, so now people are really starting to pay attention to this. Mm-hmm. For people that maybe don't know that much about you, who are you and why do you want to do this job of controller, which a lot of people don't know what the controller even does?
Well, the controller is the person who's supposed to give us accountability for every dollar we spend as a state. Think of it as the fiscal watchdog of our state. I grew up in Southern California. I grew up in Roland Heights, which is a suburb of L.A., Dodger fan, Laker fan. My parents are immigrants from Taiwan. My wife and I have two kids, and we live in the Bay Area now. As a native Californian and somebody who's seen what's happened in our state, I think I've grown frustrated with our inability to solve big problems. And I think the controller can give us accountability and demand results for $300 billion in state spending a year. So for me, this is very personal. It's about how do we make California better for my kids and my grandkids.
So that's the case for you. What's the case against Malia Cohen?
Well, you know, she's had a really checkered background. And particularly for a job like this, when you need to be somebody who understands the economy, the controller helps to oversee the fifth largest economy in the world. Malia Cohen can't even handle her own finances. How can we expect her to be somebody who can handle finances for the state of California?
And that's part of what you talked about in that ad that we just played. She keeps bringing up the issue of abortion over and over again. Here's one of her latest ads.
Republicans like Lanhee Chen put abortion at risk, even in California. Chen supports Trump Republicans pushing a national abortion ban and refuses to support the amendment to enshrine the right to abortion in the California Constitution.
So, first off, is that true? And secondly, how much does the controller even have to do with abortion?
Not a whole lot, but it's absolutely untrue. I'm pro-choice. Our positions aren't all that different on this issue. And I would also say that the controller does not have the power, the authority, nor would I as controller have the inclination to do anything about abortion funding. The rules and the laws regarding abortion in this state are well set and well established. And as someone who's pro-choice, I would defend and continue to ensure access to reproductive rights for women across this state. So it's not an issue. She's doing this guilt by association game. It's the only argument she has, and it's the only one that she feels comfortable using, so that's what they're going to do.
Do you support, though, Prop 1, which would be a constitutional right to an abortion?
I'm studying it like a lot of Californians are. I would support enshrining our current law into the Constitution on abortion. I'm not sure Prop 1 does that. I've heard from both people who are for abortion and against abortion that Prop 1 is deeply challenging, and so we're going to look at it like a lot of other voters across this state, and we'll see.
We've offered to host a debate for this race. You would be happy to have a debate
Absolutely.
With Malia Cohen. She hasn't agreed to a single debate with you anywhere.
Not only has she not agreed, she's turned down debate invitations across this state. I think there's a certain arrogance about my opponent that she's unwilling to sit with journalists and before voters in this state to compare and contrast visions. So I hope she changes her mind. I don't think she will, but we need to have a debate. That's what democracy is about.
Let's talk about gas prices, which is one of the biggest issues on people's mind right now. We've seen the price just skyrocket in California, much higher than almost anywhere else in the country. What can you do as controller to help oversee that, to regulate that, to investigate what's going on?
We need to audit the gas tax. That's something the controller can do. Figure out where all of this gas tax money is going. We pay 54 cents a gallon in state excise taxes on every gallon of gas that's sold and purchased in California. Is that money going to what the state says it's actually going to? And this applies not just to gas taxes, by the way. This is to all the revenue the state is collecting. Are we actually getting results for our spending? In the case of the gas tax, we've seen gas prices spiking here in LA, across the state. Let's figure out where that money is going. One of the first things I want to do as controller that I'd have the power to do is to audit the gas tax.
And real quickly, 30 seconds, California could be heading off a fiscal cliff when we look at what could be coming next year. Yeah. What's the biggest thing you do as controller if that happens, if we see revenues go way down?
Well, we have to be sure that every dollar we're spending is impactful. If we have fewer dollars to spend because the economy's not doing well, tax collections are down, let's make sure we're getting results for our spending on education, on healthcare, on homelessness. Right now, we're not getting those results. I'm going to be focused on delivering results and transparency for every dollar the state spends. It's a vision for this state that I think is long overdue and something that I have the background and experience to deliver.
Lastly, you know, we always like to have fun on this show.
Yeah.
We play a game called Personal Issues, which we played with you recently. And when we played with you, you said that your favorite band or musical artist is Boyz II Men.
That is true.
Which surprised me. So we're going to go to break with some Boyz II Men.
Okay.
And a chance for you to break it down.
Okay.
Lanhee Chen,
right.
Thanks for being with
Thank
us.
Thank you.
Boyz II Men, take
Thank
it away. Thanks for watching this week. A reminder to download the Issue Is podcast for bonus content and extended interviews. Just search for The Issue Is wherever you stream. We end with music from Fleetwood Mac featuring the USC Trojan Marching Band and the Above Los Angeles account taking us above Venice Beach at sunset. Fight on. I'll see you next week.